guys, it's Aoife from Words of Clover, and I'm here to talk about Irish books you should read if you like these Irish TV shows. Or if you like these Irish books, maybe you should try this Irish TV show. It can work either way. I'm hoping I'll have this up on St. Patrick's Day, so if so, happy St. Patrick's Day. And I just wanted to, again, celebrate everything Irish, as I always like to do during the Irish Readathon, and talk about some great Irish, I guess, contributions to both TV and to books. The first TV show I want to talk about is Derry Girls, one of the absolute favourites that have come out in recent years. It's just absolutely hilarious about these bunch of girls and one English boy growing up in Derry during the end of the Troubles, so in the 90s.
Look, whatever happens in there, we have to stick together, okay? We have to back each other up.
Ladies.
So it had nothing to do with me. Yes, okay, I was there, I admit. It was all Michelle. I'm not going down for something I didn't do. If anyone deserves to get punished, it should be Michelle.
Well, I think it's safe to say we all just lost a bit of respect for you there, Claire.
Book I would recommend checking out if you like Derry Girls is Big Girl, Small Town by Michelle Gallen. Now, this is a book that is set kind of shortly after the Troubles. We are following a young woman who works in the local chipper. She doesn't have a lot of like real expectations for her life. She's just, you know, every day like getting up, and her mother is an alcoholic, and she is dealing with like looking after her mother every day, and then also there is some kind of like question marks around her father. Her father, I think, maybe disappeared during the Troubles and may have had ties to the IRA or ties to like some organization during the Troubles. And yeah, there's kind of like a lot of what ifs, like what happened there, and there's not a whole lot of closure either. Her character is also dealing with grief, as her grandmother has recently died, so she is kind of trying to hold all of that in. And again, every day, just going to the chipper, going through the motion. There's something really like quintessentially Irish about the whole like chipper part of this book, because chippers, which is like the fish and chip shop, is definitely like a very favourite of Irish cuisine, Irish takeaway. Fish and chips is, yeah, as you can see maybe in that about the there is a scene in Derry Girls in a chip shop, and where they're like debating about how many chips they should get. Just quite an interesting novel. And one of the things I really liked about this book as well, it's kind of, it's not explicitly stated, but it's kind of implied that the main character may be neurodivergent. She may be on the autistic spectrum. So you see her interactions with people, you see how she views the world and how she goes about her life and how she makes decisions. And yeah, I just was really interested reading that book, knowing that going in and reading the character and seeing how the character reacted and how she communicated with people. Yeah, I just found that really interesting to read. Another absolute favorite of the past few years when it comes to Irish TV shows is of course Normal People, which was adapted by the book by Sally Rooney. I'm going to be obviously recommending a Sally Rooney book, though I would recommend, if you do like Normal People the show, to read Sally Rooney, because she is the creator of these characters and the type of like miscommunication and all sorts that you do see in Normal People.
Do you like me? By the photocopier, you said it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you mean like as a friend or what?
No. Not just as a friend.
Yeah, I thought that might be implied, I just wasn't sure.
But a book that I recently read that I absolutely loved, and I do think fits a lot of the themes that we do see in Normal People, is Snowflake by Louise Nealon. And this, again, we're following a girl. She's just about turned 18, kind of 18, 19 years old. She has just left school and she is about to start her first year in college in Dublin. And she is commuting from her dairy farm that she lives on with her uncle and her mum, and she is commuting like back and forth between Kildare and Dublin. So she's going from like quite a small kind of farming community in a small like village to then going into Dublin and kind of being a little bit like awestruck and intimidated by Dublin and like by the amount of people and like not knowing how to suddenly go from like being a child to being an adult. And she does have some mental health troubles. We see her really have to face up to some of the things that she's feeling and like the thoughts that she is thinking, and also come to terms with some of the things in her own family. We see her have to seek mental health advice and get therapy, which is like obviously a really healthy thing to see in a book too. But there's also like, as I also think in Normal People, in Snowflake, one of the main things in it is just love between family and also love between friends. And I just, like, it does give, like, while there are some kind of bleaker moments and sad moments and moments that you really worry and despair for the characters, overall there is just this almost like hopeful feeling because there is this really, really deep love. I really, really enjoy this and I do recommend it if you like normal people. The next show I want to talk about is Father Ted, obviously a really a real favorite when it comes to Irish television.
Do you remember Sister Sumter?
No.
She was here last year. And then we stayed with her in the convent, back in Kildare. Do you remember it?
Ah, you do.
And then you were hit by the car when you went down to the shops for the paper. You must remember all that. And then you won £100 with your lottery card.
Ah, you must remember it, Dougal.
Weren't you accidentally arrested for shoplifting? I remember we had to go down to the police station to get you. And the police station went on fire? And you had to be rescued by helicopter?
Do you remember? You can't remember any of that? Huh? The helicopter! When you fell out of the helicopter! Over the zoo! Do you remember the tigers? You don't remember! You were wearing your blue jumper.
Ah, Sister Assumpta, hello there!
And for this one, I want to recommend Holding by Graham Norton. This book is set in a small village in Cork, and we are following a bumbling Garda, or policeman, as a body is discovered in his town, and he's suddenly gone from having a very kind of peaceful, like, basic life, like, where he hasn't really had to do anything. Like, when it comes to his job, he's had to do, like, very little policing, and he's not really in a fit state to actually start doing policing. He almost, like, can't remember how to do it, and suddenly he has to, like, start investigating this murder and try and figure out, like, what the hell has happened and why this body has shown up. And he's kind of unearthing really, really deep secrets within the town, and he could be making some people mad when it comes to those secrets. And we see people kind of start to underestimate him because of, you know, he hasn't, like, he has just been this bumbling, almost, like, you know, policeman plod, like, character, and people don't really expect that much from him. But as he gets deeper and deeper into the investigation, into the murder, we see him gain in confidence over this. We also see him start, like, romantic relationships where he's never really been able, like, lucky in that case before. And yeah, we see him getting closer to figuring out, like, what's going on in this town. I just really enjoyed this one. I think Graham Norton's really, really good at writing small Irish towns, and, like, these, like, real and real classic Irish characters as well, and real, like, Irish stereotypes in a way, and making a little bit more out of them. And I think there's a lot of humour, obviously, in Father Ted, and I think there is humour in Holding as well, but there's also that, like, small town, like, insular feel to it too. I would pair these two together. But Mrs. Brown's Boys is an Irish TV show that was, it did start as kind of just a comedy sketch on stage, and then it turned into a TV show, and it is really, like, the quintessential Irish mother. Just a lot of laughs. It's not to be taken seriously. It can be very, very filthy at times, but at the same time hilarious. And maybe, I think it did go on, it has been going on maybe a little bit too long, and it could have been a few, like, series shorter, but the first few seasons were definitely really, really good. For this one, I wanted to kind of think about a book that it has a lot of, like, family values in it and family connection. So I've gone for The Trip of a Lifetime by Monica McInerney. Now, Monica McInerney is Irish Australian, and there is kind of a prequel book to this novel, which is the Alphabet Sisters, I think, which is set in Australia. In this book, we are actually following the granny of this family as they bring her home to Ireland, and she visits Ireland for the first time since she left it as a young girl, and we see her go on this trip with her granddaughter, and we see her kind of have to, like, think about all the things that happened to her before she left, why she left Ireland in the first place, and she's kind of, like, while at the same time she's having kind of a lovely homecoming, returning to the land of her birth, she's also having to deal with some difficult things when it comes to, like, past memories and past trauma. And also, she also has to tell the truth about some things that she may have been lying about to her family for years. But in this one, there is a true sense of family connection and family love, and we see, like, a grandmother granddaughter relationship too, which I always really, really enjoyed. It's definitely a feel-good book in the long run. While there are some sadder moments in it, it's definitely a feel-good book And I think if anyone does like particularly like kind of contemporary fiction, women's contemporary fiction, you would really enjoy this one. The next kind of comedy TV series I want to talk about is The Young Offenders. This is also based in Cork, in Cork City, and it is absolutely hilarious. And there was a movie originally about this, and then it turned into a TV show, I think, unless the TV show came first, but I think it was the movie came first, and then there was a TV show after that. And it is just about these two teenage boys in Cork City and just the absolute trouble they get into, and like really hilarious things, and they're just always getting into trouble, but at the same time they do have kind of like good hearts underneath it all, despite all the stupid things that they do.
They're looking. Make your dick look bigger, warm it up. What are you doing, boy? What the fuck? Why did you do that? I was warming up mine.
So for this one, I was kind of trying to think of a character that felt similar to these boys. So I've gone for Highfire by Eoin Colfer. Highfire is actually based in Louisiana in the States, and we are following a teenage character. He's about 15, his name is Squib, and he lives on the near the bayou in Louisiana, and he, you know, is kind of trying to do his best, but he doesn't necessarily live in like the best, like in the best situation. And he has his mother who he loves very much, but there is this like policeman who is just a real like crooked policeman and not particularly nice person, who is kind of after Squib's like mother, who I think he wants to like date her, and like they're trying to kind of get him off their case. And then one day Squib, on the bayou, he discovers a dragon called Vern, and Vern has basically been living away from society. He's just like been doing his own thing, and he doesn't want to be around people because people, you know, keep doing terrible things to dragons, and he just wants to, you know, drink his vodka and like maybe set a couple of things on fire and watch his TV shows, and that's all he wants to do. Squib and Vern kind of team up and become really like good pals, and then we see them how they eventually deal with this policeman that is on Squib's case. And yeah, there's a lot of like hijinks in this, and there's also this like real friendship between Vern and Squib. There does eventually become a bond between the two of them, and it's a lot of fun. It's like a lot of wild rides. There's a lot of like drama that happens and drama that ensues, but it is definitely a lot of fun. Some of the darker TV shows. So I wanted to recommend a book by The Fall, which is a series set in Belfast in Northern Ireland, and we are following a serial killer who sets about, and he kills women, and he lays them out in really like specific ways. And what is interesting with The Fall is that we know straight away, like we always know who the killer is, and he's played by Jamie Dornan, and Jamie Dornan is just so good in this TV show. Gillian Anderson plays the detective who is brought in from London to investigate this this case, and the dynamic between Jamie Dornan and Gillian Anderson is just brilliant.
I doubt you ever truly lose yourself.
And you have.
The thoughts, the feelings that I experience are way beyond anything that you could call fantasies. Sounds and colours are more vivid, odours more intense. My skin becomes sensitive to even the slightest of pressure. The outside world means nothing, only the interior world is real. It is utterly compelling, compulsive. Nothing can pull you back from the edge. Not laws, or threats of punishment, morality, religion, fear of death. All of those things are as meaningless as the life that you're about to extinguish.
So I wanted to recommend another book that was like a little bit darker and kind of serial killery, and so I have gone with The Dolocher. This is a book that I've talked about in the past that I really, really enjoyed. This is actually historical fiction. It is set in Georgian Dublin. And this one is actually a play on Jack the Ripper, because so it says that like Victorian London had Jack the Ripper and Georgian Dublin has Dolocher. So we are following a character. She's a female like apothecary. She runs an apothecary. She is a female, and so for that in itself is quite unusual. And we see her as she ends up mixed up with this serial killer who has been named the Dolocher, and is killing people in these really, really gruesome ways, and she has to try and figure out, along with some other people that she has teamed up with, to have to try and figure out like what is going on and who it is, who is actually behind this Dolocher, and is it a real person or is it something a little bit more supernatural, and could it be someone like haunting or like something really grotesque, like a monster out there, because that's what everyone seems to think. So yeah, this one's really atmospheric and really creepy in different ways. It's very like, it feels very dark and unsettling at times, and a little bit sometimes how the fall makes you feel. So yeah, I definitely would recommend this one if you like historical fiction, if you like mystery, if you like thriller, and also if you like the fall. Last show I wanted to talk about is Love Hate, which was quite a popular Irish TV drama about like gangs in Dublin. I mean, there's a lot of like gun violence and drugs and all sorts going on with this, like a lot of crime, and there were parts of it that went very, very dark and were quite like traumatic to watch.
The fuck is what it is, darling.
What could I do, Nidge? She saw me, she knows me.
Oh no, I'm not giving out to you. I'm saying there's gonna be some heavy shit out of this, that's all. Papers be full of it, kill a woman and all that. What happened with Elmo? I thought you had him spotted.
Yeah, I thought I had him. I don't know what happened. Ordered a pint, next minute I went to the Jacks and he was gone.
What were you doing drinking with him?
Well, he spotted me, didn't he?
Did you say something to him?
No, what are you talking about?
Well, how did he know then?
I don't know, he knew. Same as sometimes a rat won't go near a bait box.
So I wanted to go for something that felt similar, but maybe not quite as dark and not quite as disturbing as some of the scenes in Love Hate. But I'm going to recommend The Glorious Heresies by Lisa McInerney. And this one, I've talked about it previously in my Irish Women Novelists video, but I wanted to recommend it again because it is such like a brilliant book. We are following a few different people in Cork. So Love Hate is based in Dublin, The Glorious Heresies is based in Cork, but the both of them are following kind of gang life and gang violence and crime related to drugs, and also this kind of cycle of, you know, growing up in such a environment and being sucked into this type of gang culture and not really having a way out, and almost like are you always a lost cause? Can you get yourself out? If you want better, are you able to extract yourself from those situations and try and forget everything and leave things behind? And there's some really beautiful moments in The Glorious Heresies, and that really struck me when I read them. I just thought that there were some passages that were just written so gorgeously. So I definitely want more and more people to, it's already quite like a well-known, like well-loved book series. But yeah, The Glorious Heresies is just absolutely brilliant. So I definitely recommend it for people to read. So those are some Irish TV shows plus Irish books that I would recommend to people. Thank you guys so much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys again next time.